to scr1tno Knitting Project Podcast. My name is Sharon and I'm coming to you from Surrey in the UK, where I live with my family, three cats and a dog. Today is Thursday, the 19th of November 2020, and this is episode 76. Welcome if you're a new viewer. Welcome back if you're a returning viewer. Thank you so much for joining me today. I'm so sorry for my absence last week. I have a cold, which you can probably still hear in my voice. But I'm at the stage now where I sound worse than I feel. So apologies if I sound a bit huskier than normal. Going to go with it because I really, really need to podcast because I've got so much to show you. And the happy mail section's ridiculous now. So if I left it for another week, I dread to think what it would be because apparently buying yarn seems to be what I'm doing at the moment. I'm glad you enjoyed the Christmas bag swap and the cozy memory blanket tour. Luckily, I'd already recorded that before I got sick. So at least I had that to put out. So I was kind of glad I had that. And anything like that, I'm going to just call a snippet because it is like a little snip into my life. It's not a vlog. It's not a podcast. So it's just a little snip. Let's go into the first section anyway. Let's move into admin. Admin, the podcast has a Revelry group. And if you aren't on Revelry, I'm on Instagram or you can chat at the bottom in the YouTube, or you can email me on scr1tno@outlook.com. Anyways, if you want to contact me, they're great ways. We have got two knit alongs going on at the moment. We have got the square a day cowl and we have got the jumper garment knit along, which is any adult size garment. If it's less than 50% done, it can be included. And the deadline for those is the 31st of December. Now, I have some blanket news. I'm going to give you a kind of little, just a little breakdown. I'm going to try and do a standalone video to explain it all. So what I'm thinking is that we're going to do the square a day next year as well. If you want to carry on working on the blanket that you're working on, I will calculate the square a day accordingly. And it will be called a second year blanket if you've already done the first year. If you haven't quite managed to get to the end of this year with your 166 squares, that's fine. You can go into next year with your first year blanket and it'll still be your first year blanket. And you can do all the check-ins as if you were a first year. So if, say, you've already got 200 squares done, that means you've already blasted the first two check-ins without any trouble whatsoever. So, you know, hopefully by the end of your first year, which is the second year, you will get that blanket done. I'm also going to do some little certificates so that if you've completed your first year blanket, you'll get a certificate. So what I will do is put up a form in my Instagram and on Ravelry for you to complete and let me know that you've a little picture showing that you've done it, which I will do in January. And I'm going to do little certificates, so everybody who's done like their first year have got their first year blanket completed. Doesn't matter if you miss any of the check-ins, that's not a problem, as long as you've got 366 squares by the 31st of December, which is normally about the 2nd of January by the time I've closed the thread, you will be eligible. So yeah, just let me know. I will put this form up, but I'm not going to put the form up. Well, I mean, I don't need to put the form up till January anyway. So I'll put the form up later in, like, between now and then. But I'm going to do a standalone video to try and explain this a bit better. we will have some prizes for the end of year check-in. So we've got some lovely prizes for the jumper cowl as well. But yeah, I'm going to try and do a separate video for the square a day. And yes, I would love to take it into next year. I haven't quite decided what I'm going to do yet because I have got my batten. Do you know what? I'm going to finish that sentence because I've just interrupted myself. I've got my batten bird blanket, which actually would be crocheting a square a day, and that would get that finished. However, I'm going to go into that in the video because I think that would be more interesting. So what I might do is bring the options that I'm thinking for my square a day for next year and have a chat with you on that one. So look out for that video. It will happen. I'm hoping it's going to happen before the end of November because then I go into Vlogmas, which is a lot of recording anyway. Right, let's move on into the knit section. I'm having fun trying to remember what my sections are now. I've got them written down. But day one is mitts. And that is hanging out in my lovely bag, my lovely little Robin bag from Mary and the Mutts. Mary Makes on she's Mary and the Mutts on Instagram and Mary Makes on Etsy. And she makes these beautiful little bags. Oh, they're just so, they're lovely and squidgy. The interfacing she uses in them, it's lovely and squidgy, and it's really pretty. I do love Mary's bags, and she very kindly sent me this last year. And in here I have, now on the video, the Cozy Memory Blanket video and bag sort video, I said I was going to do the ice skating party mitts. I changed my mind just because they're a bit more complicated. It's an easy pattern, but I need speed, and they weren't going to be as speedy. So I have swapped it for the lovely Laura of the Lonely Knitter podcast. I have swapped it for the Show Us Your Scrap Mitts. Now, I'm not doing these scrappy as a scrappy. I'm doing these just in one colour. But I'm using these numbers and this pattern. And I have got the first one very nearly done. I have got... So, that's the first mitt. Actually, if I put it on, you'll be able to see it better, won't you? As you can see, I am using two circulars to do the thumb, which means trying these on is easy. So yeah, it's just a plain. I've done a 1x1 twisted rib at the bottom, which is different from the pattern, then plain up the hand, and a 1x1 twisted rib on the cuff, and then I'm just going to do the 1x1 twisted rib on the thumb. But yeah, I really like these. You can see I've got two stitch markers hanging off. These are both the Corner of Craft, a little gingerbread house, a little snowman. And this is lovely yarn. This is a singles, which probably means it's going to peel like crazy, but they're presents, so, you know, it's not the end of the world. And that's how it's knitting up. It's really pretty. It's Biff Sugar yarn, and it's the Cove colourway. So, am I about to run out of battery? Fun fact, the C in SCR1 stands for Cove, because that is my maiden name. Just saying. And that's one of the reasons I had to buy this yarn. But it's also very pretty in its blues, and, you know, I love it. But as you will have seen, if you saw the bag swap video, I have a shed load of singles yarn, which I've not used. So I thought, why not make gifts and mitts as in single yarn, and yeah, make a really lovely Christmas present. So I'm powering away on those. I love it. It's a neat, lovely, easy pattern to follow. I did all of that in one day, and it was quite a busy day, so I wasn't constantly knitting. Although I am coming to the conclusion I am a slightly faster knitter. But yeah, I think it's knitting on two circulars. I just think it speeds everything up. But so yeah, that's my two circulars in to do the thumb. Yeah, really like that. Highly recommend the pattern. I mean, I know I've modified it slightly, but that's just for my own personal taste. Laura's pattern's got a lovely, I think it's 1x2 twisted rib, and then there's this lovely pattern that you use to add in the scraps. So totally recommend the pattern, but I've just changed it to make my life easier. So yeah, that's day one. Mitts. So day two is jumper day, and that's hanging out in this lovely bag by Busy Pottering, who isn't making bags at the moment, but if you watch her Instagram feed, she will be making up some of her hedgehog bags to support a hedgehog charity. So yeah, go check her out see when those will be available. And this is the famous initial sweater for my middle daughter, which I really, 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 really need to get finished before Christmas. So at some point I may end up just going completely off project and having to knit this constantly, but I am using the Felix pullover pattern by Savory Knitting, but I'm not doing the lace details on the raglan decreases. However, when I make this one for me, I will do that, but I'm not going to do that yet. That's probably next year's project. So I'm using that, and then I'm doing In Tarsia in the round, but I'm cheating, which I will show you in a minute. And I'm using a chart from the Harry Potter knitting book for the letter C. Now, this is where we've got to so far. It's all bunched up. So this was one day's worth. As you can tell, of course, my middle daughter's a Gryffindor. hence the colours. I was very lucky I had this all in stash. It was never supposed to go together, but hey. So that is the letter C emerging there. Now, I completely cheated. I couldn't be bothered to do intarsia in the round. So I am stranded knitting it and I'm cutting my ends. So yes, I will have a lot of ends to sew in when I've finished, but I'm a willing end weaver, so I'm not too worried. Life is too short. I'd rather spend the time at the end weaving in the ends than trying to wrangle the intarsia in the round, because with this C, it wasn't working very well. You'd think this would be easier, but it's not. But yeah, I'm still increasing for the raglins. And I think the increases for the raglins finish around about the end of where the C is completed. I just noticed I've got a hole actually. One of my wrap and turns hasn't wrapped and turned very well. Can you see that? I will stitch that up at the end. But yeah. So yes, I am going to end up with an awful lot of ends. If all else fails, at least I can give it to her with the ends not woven in. And I can do that afterwards. At least she'll be a jumper. She can still wear it. Oh dear. Poor child. We call her, in actual fact on my WhatsApp even, we call her the forgotten middle child. Because that's what she calls herself. She's not. I have to say, she's dreadful, but this would just be so typical if I got both her sister's ones done and not hers. And it was never supposed to be like that. Originally I did Meg's first because she was the one that wanted it, and then the other two were like, oh, I want one too. So I intended to do Charlie's next, but I got the colours down and to start knitting it, and it was Katie's colours. She's the Ravenclaw. I thought it was Charlie. So, because if you knew my girls, you would think that Charlie would be the Ravenclaw and Katie would be the Gryffindor, but apparently. Anyway, yeah, so that's day, what am I on, day two, jumper day. So day three is socks, and they're hanging out in my Bertie and Poppet bag, which I love. I got this a couple of years ago, but didn't get around to using it last Christmas, so this is a brand new bag for this year. And it comes in a little needle cosy. Right, so I am doing the Mistletoe Kisses socks by Knitting Expat. And this is the Halloween colourway. Is it Halloween Loan? I can't remember. Yes, Halloween 2020 colourway from Loan of the Lonely Sock Lady. And as you can see, I have finished. I have a half-finished object. I have finished this one. Isn't it pretty? There's colours. Now, you can see that how beautiful Mina's pattern is for self-striping yarn. It just works so prettily. Yeah, so I managed to finish the first sock. And I managed to get the second sock quite a way in. So I'm nearly at the heel. Boy, am I regretting doing the eye partridge heel now. I'm like, literally, I went, why did I do that? So I'm going to have to do an eye partridge heel on this one. I mean, it's not complicated. It's the same stitches, but just in a different order. But because it's not natural, I have to think about it. But yeah, so that's how far I've got on the second sock. And I totally recommend Lone's self-striping. It's lovely. Now, there may very well be an update in the offing. So watch Lane's Instagram for when she's updating, and she should have some more. I know she's dying away like a good one at the moment. So, yeah, she should have some more self-striping. But I love it. So let's just move my progress keeper onto the other sock. There we go. So yeah, I don't think there's much more I can say about that other than I'm doing it on two circulars as usual. It's 2.5 millimeter licky needles, and I'm using a 60 stitch count. But yeah, that's day three socks. So day four is hats, and this is another busy puttering bag, little Christmas pudding that came with the Lay Family Yarn Advent Calendar from a couple of years ago. That's a pom-pom that's going with this one. And now I am doing the latest Helen Stewart knit vent pattern, which is the, I wrote it down on the piece of paper because it wasn't written on here. Let's have a look. It's called the cheering hat. So that's what it looks like. It's got a cable. Can we see the cable? So I'm not on the cable. I haven't cabled yet. I've just done the brim. And I am using, have I got the label in here? I have. I'm using Homespun House in her Letters from No One, which is merino cashmere and nylon. So I'm going through some of my luxury stash this Christmas. I'm doing merino cashmere nylon for the hats with mohair, and I'm doing singles for the mitts. And this is as far as I've got. So that's where my beginning of round is. And then that's the other end of the, what will be the cable repeat when I put the cables in. So that's how it's knitting up. It looks black on screen. It's actually kind of a navy blue, and then there's shots of teal through it. And that's a Rowan Kid Silk Haze is the mohair with this one. And I'm doing these on Knit Pro Symphonies, and these the rib is done on a 3.5mm and the hat is done on a 4.5mm. It's quite a stiff rib, I have to say. I think because it's merino cashmere held double and mohair, it's quite stiff. It's almost bulletproof. but it's much better now I've got into the main body of the hat and it's on the 4.5mm needles. But it's designed as a DK pattern, so it's just over, it's a little bit over DK when you hold them double, especially with floof or mohair. But yeah, so far I'm enjoying the pattern. It's just been acres of a 1x1 twisted rib, which I don't mind twisted rib. It's kind of my default rib, to be honest. But I will let you know how the pattern goes, hopefully next week, when I will be a bit further up it. I mean, dare I say finished. That would be good. So yeah, that's day, what day are we on? Day four hats. So day five is dishcloths, and that's hanging out in another bag by Missy Pottering that Anne very kindly gifted me this year in time for my Christmas bag swap. And in here, I've got Needle Cozy. Right, I've got a little pile of dishcloths. So this is a full ball of the sugar and cream, and this is the, is it mistletoe? Yeah, mistletoe colourway. I got this off of Amazon, and it would seem I can get two dishcloths out of one of these. So I started off doing the ones with the eyelets on the side, but I wasn't so keen on that. So I've done this one, which has not got the eyelets, and I much prefer that one. So I had that one done and that one half done last week. I finished that one and I got a whole other one done. So that's another one. And then I have got that far up the next one. So they don't take long. I can get one done in about an hour. If I knit constantly. And yeah, there's a little pile of dishcloths, a little pile of Christmas dishcloths. So I'm going to finish off So sorry, you're going to see these for a little while now. I'm going to finish off the rest of this, so I should get one and a half out of what's left here, and then I should get two more out of this one. So we should be good for Christmas dishcloths. Now, this is for me and my daughter Katie, because Katie is due to complete on her flat next month, and she has a completion date, so fingers crossed she should complete on the 11th of December. So I have everything crossed for her, and that we come out of lockdown, otherwise getting her moved is going to be fun, but that's a whole different problem. She will have half of what I've made. So I'll keep half here and she can have half. But yeah, I'm really pleased with those. And then once I've finished making the Christmas ones for us, I will start making ones for other people. And I've got this blue, and I think I've got some pink. There might even be another colour somewhere, but I've definitely got some pink, because I made a pink one earlier on in the year. But yeah, this is just the sugar and cream. It's an American make, but you can get it on Amazon. Now, when I was investigating buying this, it was during lockdown, and Amazon was the only place I could get it, but I think you can get it from other independents now. So it's worth a look to see who you can buy it from, because I'm trying to buy independent at the moment if I can, and not give all my money to Amazon. But yeah, so that's day five, dishcloths. Oh, I didn't say, hold on. Pattern. Is my pattern in here? My pattern not in here. Right, so I didn't say which pattern I'm using. But I'm using Grandma's dishcloth. This is a free pattern. If you Google that, you should find the pattern. I'm not sure it's on Revelry. I can't remember where I downloaded this from. I think I followed a link that followed a link that followed a link. And this one works really well. So give that a go. I think it's something to do with Grandma's favourite dishcloths not being available anymore, or I don't know, can't remember, but I ended up following a link from one to the other. But yeah, so that's day, what are we on, day five, dishcloths. Day six is cowl day, and that's hanging out in this lovely Jilly Makes bucket. I'm nearly finished this project. I was going to say that when I finish these projects, I am going to swap project bags, because I have quite a few Christmas ones and I'd like to get through quite a lot of them before the end of the season. So this is the Philosopher's Cowl, which is a pattern by Kay Jones of the Bakery Bears. And I'm not doing it quite the same, because Kay melds the colours together on her cowl, and the yarn I had didn't work for melding, because I'm knitting it double, so I'm striping mine. But yeah, didn't quite have enough yarn to meld it. So this is this one, and this is nearly finished now. So this is the first one. I love this. So it's got this lovely rib at the bottom, and then this is two greens kind of knitting around together, and then this is two other colours knitting around together, and then this is one of these colours and the pink, and then this is the pink and the other pink knit together. And it's actually no, just on the top here, because I'm on the rib now, this is just one colour. I'm not striping the rib, that's just one colour. So that will be it finished. I haven't got much longer to go, but I just could not finish it. So that's what I've got left of the mohair. And then this is the colour that I am using at the moment. Then when this is done, I am going to... I have these ones left. So I'm going to make a second one in the rest of these. There we go. Just about see them all. So I'm going to make a second one in the rest of these. I don't know whether I'm going to hold it together with mohair, or whether I'm going to weigh this and see how much I've got left. I have got more of this, but I do need it for another project, so I'm a bit on the fence. although I have got some pink mohair, and this is quite predominantly pink. So I don't know. I don't know what I'm going to do with this, but I'm going to try and do the meld with the next one, or a marl. Meld or a marl, not sure. But this is lovely, and it's been a joy to knit on. I've really enjoyed it. So I was there last week. And now I've got on the rest of this. I say last week, it was the week before, wasn't it? So this is 2 weeks knitting. I'm nearly done. So that's nearly another present off the list, which is cool. And I'm using Licky needles. Am I using 3.75 Licky needles for that? But that's a lovely TV knitting project, because I'm all about watching the Christmas movies at the moment. If it's a cheesy Christmas movie, I'm watching it. Right, so that's it for the end of the rotation. Next up is my Cozy Memory blanket. That's hanging out in my giant blanket bag from Busy Pottering, which it needs to this time of the year because it's massive. And here we go. So, we are right. I'm gonna show you those two first because I can see them. So, that is a hedgerow yarns, and that is a hedgerow yarns. And these are two little stitch markers. So this is a little light bulb stitch marker. That's from Sugar Tots. Most of these are going to be Sugar Tots. And that's a little penguin from Sugar Tots. These are from Advents. And now I need to find the other side. I did square off, but I didn't take any footage of it because, apparently I didn't want to do that. Right, so this is the next. Here we go. Right, so that is my most favourite stitch marker in the whole wide world. It is a little gingerbread house, and it sparkles, and it's by Sugar Tots. The lovely Christie. I love that. And the mini is Sherry Iris, which is the mini I found in that blanket bag, if you remember. That one is... Yep, that one is Hedgerow Yarns, and that is a Copo stitch marker. This one is also Hedgerow Yarns. I don't know whose stitch marker that one is. That is a Jiggles and Beans stitch marker. And that is Hedgerow Yarns. That is a Copo stitch marker. I love him. And that is a mystery mini skein, but I suspect is probably West Green Loft Yarns. that is a Jiggles and Beans Christmas pudding, and that is a mini I dyed. I dyed that using food colouring. I was really pleased with that. It reminds me of Pudsey Bear's scarf, so it's called Pudsey Bear. that is Hedgerow Yarns, and that is a random sprout stitch marker. That is also Hedgerow Yarns, and that is one that I got from Kelly. I think maybe Chapel View Crafts, but I'm not sure. So that's Kelly of Lay Family Yarn. And then that's a Robin and a Hedgerow Yarns. And I don't know where the Robin came from either. But so lots of hedgerow going in at the moment, which if you remember, I do actually buy a load of Hedgerow Yarns mini. So I kind of need to start using them. But yes, so lovely. I've just remembered that actually there's another part of... There is another acquisition that I haven't got upstairs. I'll have to bring that up next week. So that's my Cozy Memory blanket. I use 2.5mm needles on my Cozy Memory blanket. I think I'm on track, just about anyway, for my squares. I may be one in credit. I may be two in credit now, because I think I did an extra one at the weekend when I was ill. But because I kind of forgot I'd done one, then knit another one. I sort of looked at it and went, oh, now I've knit two. I was a bit spaced out at the weekend. I blame Dana's. So that's my Cozy Memory blanket. So I haven't got any other crafts this week. I haven't done any other crafts other than journaling. I have a garden journal that I've started, but I haven't got it upstairs with me, so I will show that to you next week. To be honest, I think Happy Mail's going to keep us occupied for a fair amount of time. So let's go into Happy Mail. After that interruption, I shall go back to Happy Mail. So my lovely friend Kelly, who is the dyer behind Lay Family Yarn and my favourite yarn dyer, had a huge update. She's got this massive, brilliant new club going called the Rainbow Chronicles, which is involving lots of lovely full skein yarns and mini sets and 10 gram mini sets and 5 20 gram mini sets, and they're all different. It's absolutely beautiful. Now, I couldn't get all of it. However, I have got one of the full scale skeins, which is Ophelia, which is absolutely gorgeous. And it's going to go to a new sock club that is coming out, which I will be knitting in the new year. So I'm saving that one. And then this was the mini skeins. Oh, they're beautiful. There we go. So I'm probably going to get a scrappy blanket with these, do a rainbow blanket. And that might be one of my options for my square a day for next year. So I'm not quite sure what I'm going to do yet. I'll get back to you on that. So that was that. And then there was another collection, which is the Believe collection. And the minis that went with that, these are the minis. As you can, I mean, how could I not? These are, that's a lovely label. These are just me, aren't they? Me in a mini bundle, which I absolutely loved. So this is the Believe collection. And this is from the Believe collection, and it's Beauregard. And look at those speckles. Oh, it's also going to be socks. I am very tempted to try and buy the full skeins of all of these, if they're still around and I can afford them from next year, so I can make socks in those as well. So that's going to go into the new Rainbow Chronicles sock collection, and then those are going to go into a Rainbow Chronicles blanket. Then that's going to be a sock, and those I don't know yet. I mean, to be honest, they'd be perfect for my northeasterly. So obviously I managed to pick the week to be sick where all that has arrived and all the clubs have dropped this week. So I've got so much. So also the lovely Laura of the Lonely Knitter podcast, Crafter's Balm, Mumbling Yarns, did a update as well of Christmas colours. And this is called Walking in the Air, and I really, really liked it. I just love that. Okay, Kelly's yarn is just collapsing on me. You know you've got too much yarn when it collapses. So yeah, I really love that. That's her little logo. And she was doing her first set of self-striping. And this is called Fresh. Which, again, love this. So pretty. So that was Laura's. That's got sparkling as well. Can you see? It's sparkling. So that's Laura's. So also the lovely Amy of the Stranded podcast and Stranded Dye Works had her birthday update. And I snagged a couple of Aran, which is zooming home for Christmas. Now I've got, I don't think you can see it, can you? No, it's there. It's the next one along. I've got a one of these half full with Aran, which is the yarn I need for the what's it called? Felix. That's it. The Felix sweater. So I thought I might do a fade. And I've got a couple of colours that will go really nicely with this. So I managed to snag two of these in Amy's update, and then I'm going to use that as the bottom colour and then fade up, although it's top down, so it will be the other way around. But so yeah, this is zooming home for Christmas. And then also I managed to get hold of her gingerbread house on a DK, so that is going to be a hat. Not necessarily this year, but eventually it will be a hat. I mean, I say it will be a hat. It may not. It may go into a fade jumper, because one of the things I want to do next year is, again, I don't think you can see it. It's that one there. That one there. That is all my DK, and there's quite a few single skeins in there. So I'm thinking I might try and do a fade DK jumper as well. So that'd be cool. So that was the stranded one. Right, all the rest of these are now going to be clubs. So you may need to look away. So first of all is the lovely Giddy Yarns, her Nostalgia Club. So if you've not had your 1990s Nostalgia Club, look away. There we go. Isn't that pretty? I love, love this one. It's so beautiful. All these lovely greens and oh, it's just gorgeous. Really, really pretty. So yeah, that's the 1990s Nostalgia Club. You can look back now, although you may have to look away again in a moment. So look away if you've not had your Scrappy Project Club from Woolly Goodness for November. So that's a little card. And December is up now if you want to buy it. That's the inspiration photo. And this is the yarn. Isn't it pretty? If I can hold the photo up as well. Nailed it. Really lovely. And it comes with a little stitch marker. Okay, you can look back. So pretty. So that's that one. And I told you all the clubs came at once. Also, I have the Precious Minis Clubs, I think it's called. Yeah, Precious Mini Club from Elderflower Stitches. So if you've not had opened your one yet, then look away. So that's the stitch markers that come with it this month. And that is the yarn. I've kept all these so far, so I'm thinking I might put these all into a faded blanket or even a faded jumper, but they're really pretty. So again, you can look back now. I'm not going to say too much about them, just obviously because if you just looked away, then you know I don't really want to sit there describing how beautiful they are and what colours they are. Right, so that is it. That is the end of Happy Mail. I'm sorry there was so much this week. As I said, it was just unfortunate that I took a week off and all the clubs dropped at the same time. Chatting. Okay, so obviously I've been sick. It's just been a cold. It hasn't been anything sinister. It just made me feel a bit rough. This time last week, it was so bad that this time last week, because it's Thursday, on a Thursday at 5:30, I have a brownie Zoom. Well, I slept through it last week. I didn't even remember it until the other leader messaged me and went, where were you tonight? I just couldn't believe it. I've never done anything like that. That's been awful. So I was really quite unwell. Amy, you can still hear it. But as I said, I'm at the stage now where I actually sound worse than I feel. So it's a good sign. Although it looks like Ian's going down with it. So that's going to be fun, isn't it? It's really awful because he's really sympathetic and looks after me when I'm sick. And I'm just like, no, get on with it. So I need to not to be like that. I need to be sympathetic, because it is a horrible one. It does make you feel pretty rough. So as I said earlier, Katie's got completion date, so fingers crossed for the 11th of December. I mean, it couldn't be a worse time, could it, really, than the middle of the run-up to Christmas. I'll be doing Vlogmas. The house is going to be turned upside down by them moving out, so it's going to be interesting Vlogmas, at least. But I am going to try and get our Christmas decorations up bit by bit in the next few days to see whether I can get everything up before they go. Although there's probably no point in decorating the front of the house for the moment. So yeah, we'll see. I probably won't be in my new craft room until the new year, because the bit between Christmas and New Year would be the ideal time to move everything, all the rooms around. And as Charlie and Reese are moving into Katie and Dan's room, it's not just me that's moving, because I would do it and get it done, but others not so much. Anything else to report? Obviously, we're still under lockdown here in the UK. Hasn't really impacted my family at all, apart from the fact that me and Ian can't go out on our Friday adventures. So yeah, the only person that's really impacted in this household is me. I'm the only one that's not been out since the start of lockdown, but everybody else has kind of had to go out for their job. And Ian goes out every day and rides his bike, but that's slightly different because that's going out for his exercise. I haven't exercised for a week and I'm missing that, but when you can't breathe, it's quite difficult to exercise as well. I'm hoping, fingers crossed, to get back to that tomorrow. That is my aim, is to get back to exercising from tomorrow. Anything else I need to chat to you about? I'm really enjoying the Christmas knitting project. I'm enjoying getting the gifts knitted. I'm trying to get myself into a routine at the moment of kind of wrapping a few presents a day, so that it's not too much, because I've got so many little things this year, because I didn't really buy any major stuff, but it just means you've got lots of little things to wrap. So, and it still takes the same amount of time, doesn't it? It's still the same number of folds of paper, even if it's just smaller paper. I'm into my garden at the moment. I'm planting all my bulbs, so when you see my garden journal, I'll explain a bit more, but I've planted snowdrops in a tub, I've planted crocuses in a tub and hyacinths in a tub, and then in the main bed I have planted bluebells, although the cats dug up one set of bluebells so I had to replant them, some peonies, and what did I plant yesterday? Tulips. I have still got daffodils, well, narcissi, and something else. What's the other thing I've got? I can't think what they're called. Allium. I've still got some alliums to plant, so I believe they all need to be in by the end of December, so I do need to get on with it. And I've got something like 200 bulbs to plant. I have, however, got a handy tool called a bulb planter, and that is making my life so much easier. I also want to get it done before we get any hard frost, so while the ground is still really soggy, at least it's easy to plant it, even if it is a tad muddy. I have bought myself some little shorty welly boots, so that I don't have to wear my walking boots in the garden all the time. But yeah, I mean, I'm enjoying planting the bulbs, to be fair. I'm trying to just do like 10 a day, so it doesn't get too arduous. But I'm really looking forward to seeing all the colour in the garden next year. I think that's going to be really cool to see these bulbs come up. So fingers crossed they all work. I'm going to make my cake this weekend, my Christmas cake, which I'm hoping that I will video either for next week's podcast or part of Vlogmas, depending on what I decide to do with it. I need to make three this year. I'm making one for us, I'm making one for Dan because he really loves fruitcake, and I'm making one for my father-in-law because he requested one last year, so I said I would make one. That'll be fun. So I'm putting the fruit into soak for ours tonight, so I'm making ours tomorrow, putting the fruit into soak for Rob's, my father-in-law, on tomorrow night, so I'll make that on Saturday, and then I'm going to put the fruit in for Dan's on Sunday evening and make that Monday, because Sunday we're cooking a roast, so I can't really take up the oven for 3 hours with a Christmas cake. That wouldn't really work. So yeah, I need to stagger them a bit. But I do need to remember to put the fruit on to soak tonight. And the Delia Smith, I mean, I'm sure there's lots of you out there that use the same same recipe as I do, which is Delia Smith's Christmas cake. It's brilliant because it says heat the oven to, line the tin, and then it says soak the fruit overnight. So if you haven't pre-read the recipe, that's always a bit of a surprise. It did take me by surprise the first time I did it after, because I hadn't made a Christmas cake in years. And then I started making them about 7-8 years ago, I guess, when the kids were older and I had time. And yeah, that threw me the first time I looked at it. I went, oh, okay, well, let's turn the oven off and soak the fruit. So I'm going to soak the fruit tonight. Right, I think that's it for me today. I think I rambled long enough. I hope you've enjoyed it. Thank you so much for joining me. Thank you so much for your comments. I love reading them. That's all for me today. Hope you're all okay. I hope you've enjoyed this episode. As again, sorry about my absence last week. I don't like disappearing without warning, but when you get sick, there's not much you can do about it. But hopefully we're back on schedule now, at least until Vlogmas, and then you get to put up with me daily. You poor things. Right, I had better get this cleared up and get myself sorted ready for work. So I hope you're all okay wherever you are. Take care, and I will see you next week. So happy mail. My lovely friend Kelly, who is the dyer behind Lay Family Yarn and my favourite yarn dyer. Bear with me. This one doesn't often say hi on the podcast. There you go. This is Luna. Luna was named after Luna Lovegood. And then we found out he was a boy. So now he's Luna after Lunar Eclipse because he's black. Aren't you? Hey? Or Lucifer, depending on his mood. So are you just going to cause chaos? Did you just come in for, you know, hello? Are you just coming to cause chaos? Are you going to stay? Or are you just going to prowl around and be a pain in the butt? Oh, this is the longest he's had a cuddle in ages. Right, down you go.